Hi everyone, my name is Saki and I'm the Health and Wellness Educator at Boston Children's Museum.
And my name is Alissa and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum.
So Alissa, are you ready to talk about one of my favorite things?
Sure. And you know, I like talking about it too.
I know. So should we tell everyone what we are talking about?
Yep, on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Snot! Why do you like talking about snot, Saki?
Well, people often think snot is just gross, and it kind of is, but actually snot has this important job to keep us all healthy. How about you, Alissa?
I like talking about it because I'm fascinated by how our bodies work, especially when it comes to the gross stuff. So I can talk about the chemistry of snot and what it's made of.
Sure. And I will explain why it's so important to our health.
Sounds good. Here we go.
So let's get down to making some artificial snot. The first thing we'll need is some unflavored gelatin. This is basically the same stuff as Jell-O, only it doesn't have all the sugar and the flavors in it. And we'll dissolve it in some hot water. Now, one of the things that the mucus in your nose is made of is a certain kind of protein. And this gelatin represents that protein in your snot. And I know you can't really tell this over a video, but I have to say that this gelatin, this unflavored, unscented, un-anything gelatin with hot water, does not smell very good. Okay, so it's just sort of a thick liquid. Another thing that your snot is made of is some sugars and salts. So I'm going to add some corn syrup to represent that. Now, when I say sugars and salts, it's not the same as the sugar that you use when you make cookies or the salt that you put on your popcorn. There are lots of different kinds of sugars and salts. And there's also lots of different kinds of proteins. The food that you eat breaks down, and some of it is rebuilt to make these different kinds of sugars, salts, proteins, carbohydrates, and all the kinds of things that your body needs to build you and keep you healthy. So what we have here is this sort of thick, very sticky, gloppy stuff that looks a lot like the snot in your nose. And the fact that it's thick and sticky and gloppy are what makes it so great for keeping you healthy. So I'm going to turn it over to Saki to tell you all about that.
Thank you, Alissa. That was really interesting. Now I want to talk about why the snot is good for our health. To talk about it, we need to understand what germs do. Germs are very tiny and you cannot see them. But they are everywhere and that's perfectly normal. But sometimes when they get inside of your body, they can make you sick. And I bet a lot of you do not like to get sick, right? Well, the good news is that your snot will help you reduce the chance of you getting sick. So how does that work? Well, as I said, the real germs are too small to see. So today we use some cookie crumbs to pretend that they are germs. Using the pretend germs, with the fake snot Alissa taught you how to make, let's see what's going to happen. inside the nose, there's snot, which is keeping the lining of your nose nice and moist. Now, germs are getting inside your nose. And more germs are coming in. But look, the snot is trapping the germs. See? The hair in your nose can help move the snot. But right now I'm just using a stick to do the job. The germs can get inside your nose from the air, and that's perfectly normal. There are also other things like dust. And see how the snot is turning into a blob? Well, have you seen something like this? Yeah, I mean, it might be a smaller scale, but does it look like something you find inside your nose? Maybe you are right. The boogers. So what you're seeing right now is how the snot is catching the germs before the germs can even get inside your body. So it might feel really gross, but it's very important. Oh, this is so gross and great. So remember, these cookie crumbs are pretty germs. What if you ate your boogers? What would you be eating? Well, the germs, right? The snot did all the hard work to stop the germs from getting inside your body. But if you ate your boogers, you will be undoing the work that the snot did for you. Also, this is the reason why you don't want to pick your nose, because you will be touching the germs. So make sure you are using a tissue and wash your hands afterwards. And never eat your boogers.
Wow, Saki, that was really cool.
Thank you.
Hey, do you want to hear a joke?
Sure.
Why was the nose feeling sad?
I don't know.
Because it didn't get picked.
Well, Alissa, well, I think we should wrap up before you tell any more bad jokes.
Oh, Saki, that's not very nice. Oh, I cracked myself.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining us today to learn about snot. We hope you learned a lot.
Right. And we'll see you next time. Who knows what you'll find out? Bye, Saki. See you later.
Bye.